Welcome back to another Watch Along. My name is Ben, and today we go back to 2014. It's the beautiful game Spurs. We're going to look at the amazing coaching of Gregg Popovich, what this team was able to do with so many different parts and role players and things of this nature, and of course the brilliance of Tony Parker. We're going to get to see some of the greatness that made him a legend and Hall of Famer and multi-time champion. So we pick it up. This is game two against the Portland Trailblazers in the second round of the postseason. And I just want to point out on this first possession, look who's on the court for the Spurs. Kawhi Leonard, a very young Kawhi Leonard, Manu Ginobili, Marco Bellinelli, Patty Mills has the ball, and Boris Diaw is playing center. So you have an extremely small, atypical lineup out there with a ton of ball handlers that can all run around, that can move and shoot. And the movement is the thing to notice. So the first play here, this is a kind of staple action the Spurs used to run. Two screens for Leonard coming out of the corner. Patty Mills can loop into the other corner. Ginobili gets a screen from Boris Diaw at the elbow. He can go either way. And now they can just flow into two-man action with Mills giving it to Boris. And he can attack and score himself. So because of all this motion, because of all the space on the court, and because they have five skilled players, Diaw has an open paint to get into. He scores, and just these same principles are going to build off each other as we go through this quarter, and this is how this team was able to play. So right now, a lot of small ball, a lot of ball handlers and guys that can make decisions, and it's a pretty vanilla game. No real superstars out there. Kawhi's pretty young. This is his third season. He's starting to develop. Second time down, right back to Boris. And again, this is just your quote-unquote center attacking a ton of space, the kind of thing we might see in 2023. And I think that's another theme of this team. They were ahead of their time. So coaching has such a big impact on defense and getting players to buy in on defense. So watch Ginobili here. Fronts his man in the high post. Boris slides over to help to provide support. So this takes away the entire initial action. They try to run pick and roll. Ginobili's there. Boris is in great position again. Good contest. Quick stop for San Antonio. And now they come down the other way. And it's a Manu Ginobili special. Brilliant bounce pass. So moving, screening, cutting, positioning yourself, passing. He waited on that one. Great delivery. And again, that's your quote-unquote center in this small ball lineup, outrunning everyone down the court. Great little touch and dexterity to finish. So it's seven quick points for Boris, as John Barry just mentioned on the call. And here's another little subtle defensive thing. The Spurs want to push this pick and roll toward the sideline. So Ginobili, his job is to jump out, take away the middle, does it perfectly. Patty Mills is pinched over on the weak side down low. Kawhi Leonard is in good position to slide over and help out. And Bellinelli, he's the last player on the string. He's not way out of the three-point line. He gets deep so he can help out in the paint. So help the helper, help the helper's helper, rotate. Diaw gets a block. Now they instantly push it the other way. Kawhi just pulls up and is developing Kawhi Leonard. But what's the thing he's developing? That shot, that pull-up game. So that's nine quick points for the Spurs in about 98 seconds or so. And there's no traditional superstars on the court. Little full court pressure, just throw a different look. Make it a little harder to get into your offense. There's Ginobili pushing that catch out high. That's a pretty good look for the Blazers there, but a long two is what you'll take defensively. They get right back into it. Razzle dazzle from Manu. And so players like Marco Bellinelli, if you had a team and you lined up these guys, Diaw, Bellinelli, Ginobili off the bench, Danny Green just checked into the game, you wouldn't think they could create a lot of offensive pressure. But that's what's so amazing about this team and this coaching season.
Number one record, injuries, doesn't matter. You put Aaron Baines in game one, who hadn't played in...
So, a little empty pick and roll with Ginobili.
He's a factor, it's just incredible.
Pulls the trigger there, and on this offensive rebound, it's so hard to guard the three-point line right off the bench. Danny Green comes into the game.
NBA Finals record, 27 threes.
And that's about 12 points in a really short period of time. There's Danny Green at the rim, but an incredible finish by Mo Williams, and they just push it right away. So Mo Williams is behind the play here, and Green again, green light for days, no pun intended, but 10 years ago, 2014, it was not common to necessarily have a young role player just come in and be able to shoot 3 or 4 seconds into the shot clock with such aggression like this. But this is part of the value of this roster: space the floor, push the ball, take advantage of this. And this is just an avalanche from the Spurs bench, and I don't know what could be more beautiful game, 2014 Spurs, than their bench coming in and with an offensive explosion like this. So after the Portland timeout, now we've got, I mean, this is just mad scientist stuff. Man, Tim Duncan and Thiago Splitter are now in the game. So they have twin towers, basically. Two non-shooting big men. Tony Parker checks in for the first time. Parker's on a younger Dame Lillard, chases him around the screen nicely, pushes him toward the baseline. Duncan comes over. Duncan's so long, he blocks it. Shot clock violation. So Tony Parker's not known as a great defender, but if you have the effort, if you have the technique, if you understand how to defend within the scheme context, and all this is practice and coaching and trust in your teammates, you can put together nice possessions like that. Now Parker's in. He can operate on the sideline here. Little two-man game with Splitter. Gets to the baseline. Oh my goodness. Another three. And if we run it back, this is just so subtle. Bellinelli on the weak side as Parker probes and sort of draws all this defensive attention. He slides to the corner. Another great shot. That's 18 points in 3 minutes and 20 seconds.
The Spurs a 15-point lead. They're shooting 61%, and they're 5 of 6 from 3.
And contrast that with what's happening on the other end. I mean, this is just an isolated post-up for LaMarcus Aldridge. And he can make that shot, but now they push it right back down your throat. Green up fake, beats his man. Duncan touch pass back to Green. An actual miss, but you hustle down the court. Now you have rebounders in size. They had an advantage. And because of all that little touch passing, pushing, there weren't enough defenders, basically, to block out Splitter, so he gets the putback. Right off the make. So the ball goes in. The Spurs running down court in position. Duncan runs to the block. The space everywhere else. High pick and roll. And then right into the motion. Handoff, pass, cut. Look for the back door. Now they reset with Parker. Little two-man game with Duncan. Gets it to Tim for a good shot. A miss, but Splitter gets it. And here we go again. Another three on the offensive rebound. So he spaced the floor with shooters, and it makes the rebounds more dangerous, because in, you know, basketball 10 years ago, if you're dropping back a little bit with your guards to help out on the defensive glass and you get one of these offensive rebounds, immediately kick it to a shooter. And the one thing these guys could really do is understand how to, you know, move into open position and hit threes. Bellinelli and Danny Green specifically in this lineup. So we played 4.5 minutes. It's about 23-5 or something. Blazers get on the board there. Duncan at the top. Here comes Danny Green out of the corner off those staggered screens. Parker spaces the floor. Now they're stuck and they reset, pick and roll. Bellinelli. And when it's going, it's going. So he's not the same on-ball threat that Tony Parker is. But if you have space and you can reset into good position, he can make a jumper like that off a dribble. And this was a hallmark of this team, taking a good shot, looking for a great shot. Tony Parker, on this pick and roll, has space for a shot he's very comfortable to hit. This little 18-foot pull-up when they go under the screen. But you keep looking for something great. So Green moves to the corner. Backdoor. And they almost get the layup. It might have been the wrong call, but just the principle of it. Parker passes back to Danny Green. When Danny Green passes to Splitter, he heads right back door, just constantly pressuring the defense. And to me, this is a lot more of what basketball looks like now, a decade later, than what a lot of teams played like back then. The Blazers here represent a more traditional kind of offensive option. That's a nice pick and roll set. Second missed dunk in a row. But the Spurs are just, there's a concept called point five. You'll hear coaches talk about. Make a decision in half a second. Get the ball, make a quick decision. Don't have it stick. Take a good shot, look for a great shot. These are the principles you're seeing here, along with some missed dunks. So Parker has set up an empty side pick and roll. You see a lot of this today. The shooter's space to the near side of our screen here. And he probes all the way around, probes and probes and probes, up fakes, works for, oh, beautiful pass. More missed layups. That just gives us a chance to watch more Spurs offensive possessions, so I can't complain too much. But Parker's so deadly with the dribble, so he can probe and probe. Very underrated passer. Great footwork. He was so good at up and unders and holding the pivot foot in the lane. And you saw a perfect example there where he created an opening by just working and working and working and being patient. Now, this is a set that is incredibly common. Two screeners at the elbow, two shooters in the corner, spread the floor. Parker can use either screen, goes left. And if you play it too traditionally, he's too quick. Even in 2014, his 13th season in the NBA. Of course, it came in when he was a teenager. Still pretty fast, even at this point. Well, that's what makes him so difficult. And that was just his speed, his hesitation. And if you're too vanilla in your coverage, he's going to take that mid-range shot. We haven't seen it yet. Or he's going to get by you and get into the paint. Score if no one's there. Oh, another offensive rebound. That's just hustle and effort from Tiago Splitter. So we saw the beginning of the quarter, the small ball lineup, the decision-making, the three-point blitz. Now the big men hitting the offensive glass. Get another chance here on the free throw. So this, let's see what they set up off the timeout. It's a curl for Bellinelli. He gets it back to Parker. He takes the three, a rare miss. I mean, the shot quality for this team is just so good. And another pretty good defensive possession. Lillard tried to drive it at Parker there, just got a hand up, contest, solid footwork. And Ginobili comes back in. So Ginobili gives you more passing, a little more on ball. Of course, unlike Parker, Ginobili came into this dynasty when he was older. So he's ahead in years despite coming in a season after, playing a bench role in this team. There's that same setup, two shooters in the corner. They get into the pick and roll. Patient pass from Parker to Green in the corner, and a rare miss. That went just in and out, but again, wide open shots. And it's a three, you know, the Spurs are hitting and missing some of these threes, but it's long twos for the Blazers because of the era difference. Kind of like San Antonio's playing in the future. Oh, that was a beautiful pass from Tony Parker. Let's run that back. The spacing, you see this today, empty pick and roll setup. Portland wants to push him left down toward the baseline. The two shooters are spaced out. Duncan's on the far block. Parker turns the corner. We saw this earlier. Patient, uses the footwork, up fake, pivot foot, great pass. It's fantastic basketball. That time they actually switched Parker off Lillard and Dame was able to get by, but then they're right back into it. Portland is already in position to push him to the sideline to handle this pick and roll. So Splitter just stays wide. He doesn't come over and set it. Parker wraps the pass around to him. That gets him deep. Kind of loses it here. And Ginobili with the extra pass. So you put good passers out there. You put good shooters. You space the floor. It's an offensive clinic without having a traditional offensive superstar like a Dame Lillard who can ignite, or James Harden or Steph Curry. Or there's no singular force. Parker, of course, is on ball, and he's dangerous with the dribble. He can probe and get places. Extra pass, another three. Ginobili can shoot. Unselfishness of Tim Duncan. That was that same empty side pick and roll action. Portland had to bring an extra defender over. That frees up the extra pass. I believe the Spurs in this quarter alone had 13 assists. 12 or 13 assists. I mean, it's would be on pace for about 50 in a game. Just for perspective, I believe the NBA record is 52 or 53 assists in a single game. Kawhi Leonard comes back in now. Green out. Always shuffling in little options that fit with the system. A decision maker, a passer, a ball handler. Parker, of course, their most dangerous ball handler. A defender, a shooter. Kawhi's man defense. His three-point shooting itself. So Ginobili's in the corner. The play kind of stifles out. What can you reset with Tony Parker pick and roll? Spurs up 1-0. Series shifts to Portland Saturday night. This time he takes the pull up. Ooh, just leaves it short, but that's his shot. He made a career knocking down 8 to 16 footers off that type of action. Tim Duncan's length, blocking shots at the rim. So this team is about maximizing the pieces. I think when you look at some of the lineup data, it's like a Gregg Popovich work of art that should be hung in a museum. You have these lineups with Patty Mills and Aaron Baines and Danny Green, and yet they're able to compete or sometimes outscore other teams. Good offense, principled position defense, communicating. Tiago Splitter. Just shuffling these guys in and out of the lineup right now.
Switching it. I know you don't want your big guy playing Tony Parker, but maybe that'll work. I mean, you got to just give them different looks.
And now this is one of the most common plays in the league today. A down screen in the corner for a handoff action. Ginobili coming up to get the handoff from Duncan. He can get in the paint. Little ball fake. Just blocked. So we've seen so many staple sets. Empty side pick and roll. Horns, screens. Screens into handoffs. It's exactly what you'd see from offense today. Here's Parker getting free. There he knocks one down. I mean, that is not a shot you want to give him repeatedly. It's a money shot for him. And again, contrast that to Portland isolating a big in the post. Just a totally different style of offense and basketball.
Found Barton for a layup. They haven't doubled any other time since.
And another long two from the Blazers. So this is their version of a post-up. Duncan's not necessarily catching it to score. He's catching it so Tony Parker can chase the pass. They ran this play forever. It's well defended, but this would get a layup like 20% of the time just trying to handle that cut. What's your reset option? Ginobili, he can run pick and roll, gets in the paint, just leaves the floater short, but great effort on the offensive glass to keep it alive. That's a Manu special. And now they go right back to the same action with Parker under the screen, and he makes you pay. So teams went under the screen because they want to force him to shoot. They might not mind a longer jumper, but he was just so good at blending that in with when can I attack, when can I break down the defense and start pivoting around and setting up teammates or hitting wild shots or just take the 16-footer. Oh, defensive intensity leads to a steal. And the one thing we haven't seen from Parker in this game that's sort of the other pillar of what made him so devastating at times offensively is transition. That speed as a one-man fast break to just push two-on-ones, take turnovers, and turn them into offense. There you see on the replay, Lillard going under, all that space, easy elbow jumper. Duncan fakes the handoff, gets it to Ginobili, another runner short. But again, just movement, three-man actions, fakes, cuts, and then Manu makes up for it with a steal. Gives it right back. But Ginobili's such an underrated, just a fantastic guard defender for so much of his career. Speaking of fantastic defenders, the length of Tim Duncan, here comes Parker in transition. It's a 2-on-2. Oh, that is vintage Tony Parker. Waiting for the screen, great hustle. Watch Tim Duncan. He puts his head down and starts sprinting. Why? Because the positioning of him in the paint allows Parker to cut back, use him as a screen, scoop it in. It's just vintage Spurs basketball.
Beautiful offense by the Spurs in transition. So crafty to use Duncan. Lillard lost track of where Tony went. He went around Duncan and gets the layup to go. Batum from outside, rattles out, and Duncan with the board. And a Portland foul, Duncan will go to the line. That's the 15 foul on the Blazers. Now Lopez
a little upset. And they're in the penalty there on the loose ball foul.
He felt like Duncan fouled him that time, a little frustration.
They're going to go back to the big lineup. I mean, just fascinating, the different combinations of players that they could put out there. Duncan misses the second. But I believe I think there's 39 points in this quarter. They only missed a couple threes. They made a ton of those. Great defense. Two-man game. There's the footwork from Parker. Up and under to punctuate the period is perfect. It's a 41-point quarter. Without playing at a ton of pace, without having an individual take over the quarter. Just an absolute basketball clinic. They finished with 12 assists in the quarter alone. 5 of 7 from downtown. Whew. I hope you enjoyed that one as much as I did. On both ends, we got to see Gregg Popovich, the coaching, the principles, the things that made them the beautiful game Spurs. And then you can just go to Tony Parker, on-ball quickness, creation, pick and roll. You can fall back on that. You can start the possession with that. Extra passes, taking good shots, getting great shots. Absolute basketball clinic.